So in the previous lecture, we have discussed the electric field strength due to a circular loop, due to a uniformly charged circular loop. So in this lecture, we are going to find the expression of electric field strength due to a uniformly charged circular disc. So instead of a loop, we will have whole disc which will be charged uniformly. So earlier, the charge was only on the circumference because we were considering the circular loop. So there is no charge which is present inside, but over here we are considering circular disc, means there is a charge present inside the disc also. So the charge is present on the circumference as well as the charge is present on the surface which is within the circumference. So this makes up the circular disc. So this whole circular disc, it will be uniformly charged, means charge will be distributed uniformly on the surface. So we will be considering here sigma, which is the surface charge density. So let's say sigma, it is the surface charge density. So what is surface charge density? It is the charge, total charge divided by total area on which that charge is distributed. So this gives us the charge per unit area. So that is nothing but sigma. Now radius of the disc which we are considering, let's say the radius of this disc, it is equal to small a. So this disc of radius a, it is uniformly charged with surface charge density is equal to sigma, and we want to find the electric field strength due to this charge distribution at a point P. So P is the observation point, and let's say this axis which is joining the observation point and the center of the disc, let's say this axis, it is the x axis. So this point is lying only on the x axis. So coordinates of this point will be x, 0, 0. So firstly, what we will do, firstly, we will find the electric field strength at P point due to elementary ring. So first of all, so in the previous lecture, we had done a circular loop. So there we had only a circular loop, and we divided that circular loop into small length elements whose length was equal to dl. So there first we found electric field strength due to those small length element, and then we integrated over the whole length. But here we have a circular disc. So first of all, what we will do, we will just divide this disc into small elementary rings. So we will divide this whole circular disc into small elementary rings whose center is O. So we will divide this disc into large number of elementary rings, or you can say the circular loops whose center is same as that of the center of the disc. One such elementary ring has been shown over here with yellow color. So we will first divide this circular disc into large number of elementary rings. So such elementary rings will be drawn from this point to the circumference of this disc. So I have shown over here only one elementary ring. Let's say the distance or the radius of this elementary ring is equal to small r. So the radius of this small elementary ring which we have drawn with center at the origin O. So this ring, it has a radius of small r. So first of all, we will find the electric field strength due to this small circular ring at the point P. So first of all, we will find electric field strength due to the charge which is present on this ring only. Due to the charge which is present only on this ring, we will find electric field strength due to that charge at point capital P, and then we will integrate over distance small r. So let's say this ring which we have drawn over here, it has a thickness of dr. So I am drawing over here ring, the same ring. So this is the ring which we have drawn over here. Let's say its radius is equal to r, and let's say this small thickness of this ring it is equal to dr. So first of all we will find electric field strength at P due to elementary ring, and then we will integrate over the distance r. So first of all we will find electric field strength due to this small section, and then we will do integration over r, because over here r will be the variable. You can draw a ring of a smaller radius also, and you can draw a ring of larger radius also. So the radius, it is a variable in this case. So we will do the integration of radius at the end. And what will be the integration limits? So r, it will vary from the minimum distance, the minimum radius, it can be equal to 0. So the limits of r, it will be from 0 to the radius of the whole disk which we have considered. So the radius of the disk is equal to a. So the maximum radius of the elementary ring, it can be equal to a, and minimum radius, it can be equal to 0. So these are the integration limits. So to find the electric field strength due to this small elementary ring at point P, so we are going to use the expression that we had found in the previous lecture, that we had a circular loop. In the previous lecture, we just had a circular loop and we found out the electric field strength at any point P on the x-axis. So that electric field, it came out to be equal to, so you can go through the previous article which we have covered. So the final result of electric field which we had found, it was equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now q, it is the total charge which is on this ring, it is the total charge, into x divided by x square plus a square. Now a, it is the radius of this circular loop which we had supposed in the previous article, power 3 by 2 times I cap. So this was the electric field due to this small circular loop of radius a. So here we want to find the electric field strength due to this circular loop. So we are going to find the electric field strength due to this elementary ring. So the electric field formula, it will remain the same, because here we had a ring and here also we are talking about a ring. We have divided this circular disk into small number of rings, and first of all we will find electric field due to the ring, and then we will do the integration over the radius. So first of all we will be using the same formula that we had derived in the previous lecture. So this formula was for the case of electric field strength due to a circular loop, or you can say due to a ring. Here also we have a ring, so electric field strength formula, it will remain the same. So here we had total charge on the ring, q is the total charge on the ring, and here also we will find what is the total charge only on this yellow portion which we have drawn. So what will be the total charge? We are given by sigma. Sigma, it is the surface charge density, charge per unit area. Sigma, it is the charge per unit area. So the charge which is present only in this shaded portion, only in this yellow portion which we have drawn, so what is the charge only in this region? So what will be the charge in this region? It will be equal to sigma, which is the charge per unit area, into area of this small section, into area of this ring. So sigma into area of this ring. So what we want to find is, now we want to find area of the ring, area of this small ring, or you can say this small portion which we have drawn. What is the area of this small ring? So to find the area of this ring, what you can do is, first of all you can cut this ring at any point. Let's say you cut this ring at this point, and when you will expand or when you will open this ring, it will form a rectangle of very small thickness. So when you will cut this ring, so we want to find this area of the ring. To find the area of the ring, first of all let's say we cut this ring at this point and we open this section, so you will get a rectangle. It will almost a rectangle. So this rectangle, it will have a breadth of equal to dr. it will have breadth equal to dr because the thickness of the ring was equal to dr. So we have just opened this ring after cutting it at a particular point. So dr, it is the breadth of the rectangle. And what is the length of the rectangle? The length of the rectangle, it will be this distance, this whole circular distance, it will be the length of the rectangle, and this whole distance is nothing but the circumference of circle. This length, whole circular length, which will make up the length of the rectangle over here, this will be the circumference of the circle, and circumference of the circle is nothing but equal to 2 pi r. So what will be the area of this section? It will be equal to length into breadth, so it will be equal to 2 pi r into dr. So area of this small section, or you can say area of this small section or this yellow portion, it will be equal to 2 pi r into dr. So that will be the area of this elementary ring of radius r. It will be equal to 2 pi r into dr. So what will be the charge on this ring? It will be equal to sigma into area of the ring. So that will be equal to sigma into 2 pi r into dr. So we are going to find electric field strength due to this small elementary ring. So the formula, it will remain the same which we have derived in the previous lecture. So it will be equal to I cap. So this formula, it is only for this elementary ring. So dE vector, so we have replaced E vector with dE vector because here this ring, it acts as a small section, and total electric field, it will be the integration over this elementary ring. So the electric field due to this small ring section, it is given by dE vector. It will be equal to I cap into Q. It is the charge on this circular loop, which we had done in the previous lecture, and charge on this circular loop, we have just found, it is equal to sigma into 2 pi r into dr. So it will be equal to 2 pi r into dr. It will be 2 pi r into dr into sigma, that will be the charge on this yellow portion, divide by 4 pi epsilon naught into x. X is the distance of the observation point from the center of the ring. So that will be the same here also. We have considered x as the distance of the observation point from the center of the ring. So that will remain same, x by x square, plus here we have a square. Now a, it was the radius of the circular loop which we had considered in the previous lecture, but over here we are considering the circular ring which has a radius of r. So instead of a, we will have r in this case. So x square plus r square power 3/2. So this will give us the electric field strength due to this small elementary ring at the observation point P. So dE vector, it will be equal to I cap into 2 pi r dr into sigma. So I am writing this formula again, divide by 4 pi epsilon naught into x divide by x square plus r square power 3/2. So this is the electric field strength due to only this small elementary ring section which we had drawn. But what we want to find is electric field strength due to this whole circular disc, due to this whole circular disc of radius equal to A. So what will be the electric field? It will be equal to E vector. It will be equal to integration of dE vector. So it will be integration over the electric field due to this elementary ring. So integration of dE vector, and that will be equal to, so we are just doing the integration of this formula. We are doing integration over dE vector. So E vector, total electric field, it will be equal to integration of dE vector. So we are going to do integration of this whole formula, that will be 2 pi r dr sigma divided by 4 pi epsilon naught x divided by x square plus r square power 3/2. So here keep in mind that we are doing integration over r. So we have dr over here, which is the small thickness we had considered over here. This is the small thickness of the elementary ring. So we are doing integration over r. So the limit of r, minimum value of r it will be equal to 0, and maximum value of r it can be equal to a. So we are going to do integration over r from 0 to a. So we will take constant terms outside. So what are constant? 2 pi sigma into x divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. This is a constant value. So keep in mind, x is not a variable, x is a constant value, because we are finding electric field strength at this point only, whose distance is fixed from the origin or from the center of the disk. So x will be constant. So inside the integration, we will be just left with r into dr divide by x square plus r square power 3/2. Now we are just going to evaluate this integration. So to solve this integration, we will assume x square plus r square. X square plus r square is equal to t. So to solve this integration, r dr divided by x square plus r square power 3/2, we will assume x square plus r square is equal to t, and on doing differentiation on both sides, now keep in mind x is constant, as we have already said, x is constant. So on differentiating on both sides, you will get 2r into dr will be equal to dt. So this is after you do integration of this equation. So from here, r dr will be equal to dt divided by 2. So this integration will be equal to integration r dr. Now what is r dr? It is dt divided by 2 divided by x square plus r square. So x square plus r square, we have already assumed it is equal to t. So you will get t power 3/2. So we have to evaluate this integral. So we have changed the variable from r to t. So we have changed it to t from r. So this will be equal to 1/2 into integration of dt divided by t power 3/2. So that can be written as 1/2 into integration of t power minus 3/2 into dt. So on solving this integral, you will get 1/2 into t power minus 3/2 plus 1 over minus 3/2 plus 1. That will be equal to 1/2 into t power minus 1/2 divided by minus 1/2. That will give you minus, so 2 and 2 will cancel with each other. So you will get minus 1/2. So this is what you will get on evaluating this integral, and we will substitute the expression of t. So what is t? It is equal to x square plus r square. So you will get minus 1/x² + r² / 1/2. So this is what this integration will be equal to. It will be equal to minus 1/x² + r² / 1/2. So this expression which we were solving of electric field strength, it will be equal to I cap 2 pi x sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught, and this integration which we have already solved, it is equal to minus 1/x² + r² / 1/2 with the limits from 0 to a. So we are putting the limits for variable r. So x is constant and the variable is just r. So we will put the limits. It will be equal to I cap 2 pi x sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught into minus 1/x² + a² / 1/2, then plus 1/x² + 0. So you will put the lower limit, it will be equal to x² + 0 / 1/2. So you will just get x² / 1/2, and x² / 1/2 is nothing but x. So first you have put the upper limit for r is equal to a, so that you will get minus 1/x² + a² / 1/2. Then you will subtract the term after putting the lower limit, and you have already minus sign, so minus of minus will be equal to plus, and on putting r is equal to 0, you will just get 1/x. So you can switch these two terms. So you can take the positive term in the front, so it will be equal to total electric field strength at any point on the axis of the disk, it is equal to I cap 2 pi x sigma divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by x minus 1 by x square plus a square power 1 by 2. So this is the final formula for electric field strength due to a uniformly charged circular disk. We are going to do a special case for infinite sheet. So earlier we had just covered the electric field strength due to a circular disk of radius equal to a, whose radius was equal to a. So we just found electric field strength at any point which is at a distance of x from the center of the disk. So that formula, it was equal to electric field strength is equal to I cap 2 pi sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 minus x by x square plus a square power 1 by 2. So the last formula that we had just derived, it was equal to E vector I cap 2 pi x into sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by x minus 1 by x square plus a square power 1 by 2. So this was the formula that we had derived for a circular disk of radius a. So this will be equal to I cap 2 pi x sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now you will take x common from the denominator. That will be equal to x. So you will take x common from the first term, that will be equal to 1 minus. So for after getting x common from the denominator of the second term, you will just get x divided by x square plus a square power 1 by 2. So when you will open the bracket, after taking x inside the bracket, you will just get the previous equation. So x and x will cancel with each other, and electric field strength, it will be equal to I cap 2 pi sigma divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 minus x by x square plus a square power 1 by 2. So this is the formula that we have written. Now we are considering for an infinite sheet. So here we had a finite disk, a disk of a finite radius a. But what if we have infinite sheet? So what if we have infinite sheet? We have infinite uniformly charged sheet. So the radius a, it will approach to infinity in that case. So in that case, this radius, it will approach to infinity because we are talking about infinite sheet whose ends, they are not finite. So a will tend to infinity, and in this formula, when you will put a is equal to infinity, this second term, it will vanish. So this term, after putting a equal to infinity, when a will tend to infinity for infinite sheet, this second term, it will vanish, and electric field strength, it will be equal to I cap 2 pi sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 minus 0 in that particular case. So for infinite sheet, electric field strength will be equal to I cap into, now 2 pi and 4 pi, it will cancel and we will get 2 remaining in the denominator. So I cap into sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So this is the formula of electric field strength at any point for the case of infinite uniformly charged sheet. So in this case, we put a will tend to infinity, and this formula which we had found for electric field strength for a circular disk, this will get modified and we will get electric field strength is equal to I cap sigma by 2 pi epsilon naught. So here you can clearly see, here we have sigma and we have 2 epsilon naught, and there is no x term. X was the distance of the observation point where we are finding the electric field strength. So it was the distance of the observation point from the disk. But here we do not have any x term for the case of infinite sheet. It means that for infinite uniformly charged sheet, the electric field strength, it is independent of the coordinates of observation point. So let's say you take the observation point anywhere far away from the infinite sheet, or you take it very close to the infinite sheet, the electric field strength, it will remain the same because it does not depend upon the location of the observation point. So it will be constant for every observation point. The magnitude will be constant for every observation point. And here you can see we have sigma in the formula. So if sigma is positive, that is if this sheet is uniformly charged with positive charge, then sigma will be positive and electric field strength at this point on the right hand side, it will be towards the plus x axis. If sigma is positive, that is we are talking about positive charge distributed on this uniformly on this infinite sheet, so electric field strength in that case, it will point along plus I cap. So at this point, let's say the electric field will point along plus I cap, and on the left hand side, the electric field strength, if you will calculate, it will point along minus I cap. So this formula that we have derived, it is for the observation point which is present on the right hand side. So this observation point, it is present on the right hand side, and if you will do the similar derivation on the left hand side, you will get the electric field strength will be equal to minus I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So if you will do the whole derivation which we had done in the previous lecture for the case of circular loop also, and then for the case of circular disk, if you take observation point on the left hand side, so that in that case the direction of the electric field, it will get reversed. So you can do it by your own, or you can just remember that when you will take the observation point on the left hand side, the direction of the electric field strength, it will come out to be minus I cap in that case. So this is for the uniformly charged infinite sheet. The electric field strength at this point will be I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught, and at this point the electric field strength is minus I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So let's say we are taking any point very close to this charged sheet, which is it is not touching the charged sheet, but it is very close to the plane of the sheet. So at this point also, the electric field strength, it will be equal to I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. And if you will take the point on the another side of this sheet, so this is a three-dimensional picture. So if you will take a point which is just on the left hand side of this charged sheet, the electric field strength, it will be pointing along minus I cap, because this point, it will be on the left hand side. So electric field strength will be equal to minus I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So just on the right hand side of the sheet, the electric field strength, it has magnitude of sigma by 2 epsilon naught, but its direction is along plus I cap, whereas at this point, which is at this second point, which is just on the left hand side of this sheet, just on the another side of the sheet, the electric field strength is sigma by 2 epsilon naught into minus I cap. So there is a discontinuity in the electric field strength. So there is discontinuity in the electric field on the both sides of the sheet. On the one side we have I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught, and on the other side we have minus I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So there is a discontinuity due to this minus sign. So we can say that the electric field strength, it changes from I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught to minus I cap sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So there is a discontinuity. Although the magnitude it remains the same. The magnitude remains the same, but there is a difference in the direction. So electric field strength, it is discontinuous. Electric field strength is discontinuous across the sheet. So if you are looking at this point, which is on the left hand side of the sheet, and then you move across the sheet, when you will move across the sheet and you will go at another point which is on the right hand side of the sheet, the electric field strength, it will just switch its direction by 180 degrees. So here the direction was along minus I cap, and here the direction will be I cap. So there is a discontinuity in the direction of the electric field strength across the sheet. So as you will move across the sheet, the electric field strength will